These, no.
No banana. Great.
Hey everybody, it's Charlie. Hopefully you've had a chance to watch both of the Spider-Man Far From Home trailers a billion times. We need to talk about what's going to replace the Avengers Tower. Who is the person that bought it during Spider-Man Homecoming? Because as you can see Spider-Man swinging past Grand Central right in front of it, they're currently remodeling it into whoever that new tenant is. There are a couple clear indicators about who that could be, so I made a top 5 list to break down all the evidence, because obviously the Avengers Tower isn't just a big part of the Spider-Man movies, it's a big part of all the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies. So whoever replaces them is also going to be a big character in the MCU, not just the Spider-Man films. We're still doing that IMAX giveaway. All you have to do to enter is be a subscriber and leave your favorite Spider-Man villain on the video. So first big thing, because they're teasing this in Spider-Man Homecoming, because that was part of the big plot, like we're moving out, we have all these weapons that we need to move, and the Vulture was trying to take advantage of that, and now we see it in the background of the Spider-Man Far From Home trailer, the person or the people that bought it are probably important Spider-Man comic book characters that are also big MCU characters, or could become big MCU characters. So we're talking about deep cuts from the Amazing Spider-Man title, because most of the stuff that they're doing in this new Spider-Man trilogy with Tom Holland are pulling from like the first 20 or so issues of Amazing Spider-Man. I mean, there's Easter eggs from all over, but for the most part, Kevin Feige and Sony have gone back to the beginning. So that's where a lot of my picks come from. Starting with number 5, we actually have to acknowledge that it's a huge misdirect that will go nowhere, and it'll just wind up being some random outreach or charity organization that Iron Man bequeathed as part of his larger plan to help rebuild New York City after all the collateral damage since the first Avengers movie, then in Infinity War, and any additional damage that it might take during Avengers Endgame if they do have more battles with Thanos on planet Earth. But I put this lowest on my list just because, yeah, you do have to acknowledge it, but I don't think that Kevin Feige rolls like that, because it would be the least exciting payoff for fans. Like, you don't tease something like this in all these Spider-Man movies and then just pay it off saying it's some charity organization. But that is happening because we see that giant check signed by Pepper Potts, so Iron Man is clearly trying to give his own money to help people in New York City. So number 4, it could also be one of Black Panther's new offices in an outreach center. He's one of the most important characters going into Marvel Phase 4 because Iron Man and the original Avengers are transitioning to the background, one of them potentially dying. The ending of the Black Panther movie was all about him accepting his role on the world stage and taking responsibility for helping the less fortunate all over the world using the resources of Wakanda that they had previously hoarded. That's what the outreach centers are all about. Those places aren't just for science and learning, they'll also serve as bases of operation for agents of Wakanda. Remember the way they styled that movie? He's kind of like the James Bond of the Avengers, so he'll continue to travel all over the world in his sequel movies. He's one of the few people to have the money to metaphorically take the mantle from Iron Man, because it takes a lot of money to fund the Avengers, and literally the money to take his old tower, which is prime Manhattan real estate on Park Avenue. Seriously, that Avengers Tower is worth crazy amounts of money, so the only people that will be able to pay for it would be really large international corporations or big billionaires within the Marvel Cinematic Universe. The reason why this is a little bit lower on my list is because look at the design of that tower. That does not look like Wakandan-inspired architecture. The buildings that they make are this fusion of form and function with the Earth, and this looks like something that an American or just like a typical businessman would design. So what if the Black Panther, Shuri, or any of those people are going to move into a building that looks like this? If they were going to buy it and remodel it, it would look more like Wakandan architecture. So 3, we gotta say it, S.H.I.E.L.D. seems like it's coming back during Avengers Endgame in some partial way. It could be new S.H.I.E.L.D. headquarters because the government, which funds S.H.I.E.L.D., would have the money to pay for the Avengers Tower. Iron Man also loves taking money from the government since they've been such a pain in his butt. Thunderbolt Ross has been a thorn in everyone's side ever since Captain America Civil War. So it is totally possible that he made the government pay through the nose for that real estate in exchange for moving the Avengers facility to upstate New York. Like, I'll move our facility up here so there won't be as much collateral damage, but only if you buy the old building off of me for a premium. Number 2, here we get to the really deep classic Amazing Spider-Man comic book cuts. Highly unlikely that they'd be able to do them at this stage, but we have to talk about them. The Fantastic Four's Baxter Building, or tangent, Future Foundation. Almost the same thing, but not quite. Future Foundation was sort of like the next evolution of the Fantastic Four in later comics. If you haven't read those first 20 or so Amazing Spider-Man comics in a long time, Spider-Man encountered the Fantastic Four in Amazing Spider-Man number 1 at the Baxter Building. So they literally led off his title. That's like the deepest cut you could possibly make. Now, it was a brief encounter, but those first couple of years of the Amazing Spider-Man comic when he first debuted were peppered with Fantastic Four appearances. He even fought Dr. Doom before he fought Mysterio. So the only reason the Baxter Building isn't my number one pick to replace the Avengers Tower here is just because in real life, the Fox Disney deal timeline is still going out to March right now. And the fact that separately, Fox was already developing a spin-off Fantastic Four film, that Dr. Doom film. So I don't think it's very likely that Fox would have completely loaned out the Fantastic Four characters prior to Disney paying their $70+ billion to them for the whole company. Like, they're probably not going to give away the milk for free, so to speak, before Disney bought the multi-billion-dollar cow. My number one pick, location that has deep ramifications to the MCU and deep ties to the Spider-Man comics, Oscorp. We're all thinking it. We have to talk about it. There's a rumor right now that Marvel has big plans for the Norman Osborn character in the MCU that go way beyond the Sony Spider-Man films, meaning he would be a much bigger character relative to the Avengers. Like, you'd actually see him encountering other Avengers characters, not just Spider-Man in Spider-Man films. Norman Osborn is one of the few people in Marvel Comics known for buying or taking over the biggest, most expensive, splashy buildings and rebuilding them. Remember Dark Reign from the comics after Civil War? He essentially broke into Iron Man's armory and repurposed his armor to make his Iron Patriot suit. So as a villain, he's got the backstory and the resources to be this evil replacement for a Tony Stark Iron Man type figurehead. It would create a deeper link between Marvel, Sony, and the Spider-Man character, but a lot of that would depend on them signing a new sharing arrangement, which isn't really supposed to happen until this summer. So there's still a lot of stuff hanging in the air, but they've been teasing this since Spider-Man Homecoming. So obviously the big payoff is probably going to be a big Spider-Man comic book character that's also capable of being a big MCU character in general, like the biggest possible payoff for fans that you would expect. We've all seen the behind-the-scenes pictures and the rumors that they're setting up Sinister Six within Spider-Man Far From Home. Mysterio's just the main character. So if they really are going to do MCU Sinister Six, they'd need a character to bring them together with the resources to fund them. The big classic villain that's capable of doing that is Norman Osborn, Green Goblin. Now, we obviously haven't heard a whole lot about him since they started doing press junkets for Spider-Man Homecoming. People asked Amy Pascal and Kevin Feige about Norman Osborn. Are you ever going to do him again? Because they had just done him during Tobey Maguire era and Andrew Garfield era, so they didn't want to do him again right away. This is the quote that they gave.
What's fun about this is the first time Spider-Man's in the MCU, and the first time he's played by an actor who is the age, essentially, that Spidey was in those comics for so long. And, as Michael Keaton does with the Vulture, we get to explore villains that we haven't seen before. Yeah. And Spidey has an amazing rose gallery.
Yeah.
So at some point, I think it might be interesting to revisit some of the characters we've seen in films before. But right now, we think there are a lot of new ones that we haven't played with yet.
Power beyond your wildest dreams, and it's only the beginning. There's only one who can stop us. Or imagine if he joined us.
So from their comments, it does sound like they hoped that they would eventually find a way to do him again. But because they had rebooted Spider-Man so many times in such a small window, they just didn't want to recycle all the stories they had already done right away, which is why you haven't heard about Oscorp or Green Goblin or Norman Osborn since Tom Holland became Spider-Man. So all you need to do at the end of Spider-Man Far From Home in some sort of post-credit scene is just show the Avengers A on the building being replaced by an O for Oscorp. And that's it. All the teaser you need to show who's coming in that third Spider-Man film. Based on all the evidence from the Tom Holland Spider-Man films, let me know in the comments, who do you think bought the Avengers Tower? Because we'll find out for sure, at least by that third Spider-Man film. Like I said, I think it's going to be a big payoff for Spider-Man comic book fans. I'm working on my review of The Punisher Season 2. That'll probably be the next video that I post tonight, so just look out for that. Congratulations, Suppy99. You're the giveaway winner from my last big Marvel video. Please email me on the About page of my channel so I can get your details. The reason we don't see the Iron Spider suit from Infinity War is probably because he gives it back to Tony Stark during Avengers Endgame, or it's some crazy time travel explainer and it never ended up happening. We'll talk more about that when we get more Avengers Endgame footage, which will probably happen at the Super Bowl. But click here to rewatch both of the Spider-Man Far From Home trailers again, and click here for all my Avengers Endgame trailer Easter eggs. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.